Welcome back to my channel, Wendy's Kooky Crochet Tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to make this really cute bucket hat with a button detail.
Yarn I'm going to be using this variegated yarn here to make the main part of the hat, and then I'm going to use this really pretty tulle yarn to make the ruffle around the hat, and then I'm going to add a button here. And I just ordered these buttons off of Amazon, so I just got it from Amazon, and they're really, really pretty little wooden buttons. So I'm going to use a button for this, and what the hook size I'm going to use is I'm going to use a 5.5 millimeter hook size. You're going to need some scissors, you're going to need your measuring tape, a stitch marker, and then you're also going to need your size chart here. And the size chart is in my community page. That's where you can find it. And I think that's it. And if you want to see the links to everything I'm using, I'll put my Amazon links in the description below. So I'm going to make it to, let's say, about between adult medium and adult large size. So the crown diameter here is going to be 6.5 to 6.75. And then the hat height is going to be 7.5 to 8 inches long. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start with a magic ring, and I'm going to go ahead and do a double one so I make sure it doesn't work its way out, because sometimes it can. And if you don't know how to make a magic ring, I will leave my link in the description below. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do double crochets in my magic ring, and I'm going to start off doing 8 double crochets in this magic ring here. And the first thing I did was I chained 2, and now I'm doing 8 double crochets in the magic ring. I'm just going to pull my magic ring tight to close it. I'm going to pull on the one and the other one. You are not wanting to pull tight all the way. Let me pull you. I'm trying to pull this one right here tighter. I think I had a hold of the wrong one earlier. So I'm just pulling one tight. This is easier for me to do it this way, so I'm pulling the one tight, and then I'm going to take the end, and I'm going to pull the other one tight, and then I'm going to slip stitch to the first one I made. And I'm chaining 2, but that chain 2 is not going to count as a stitch here, just FYI. So now I'm going to chain 2, and then I'm going to do 2 double crochets in each stitch around. So this round will have 16 double crochets in it. Again, I'm going to slip stitch to the first one I made, and I'm doing this loosely, just by the way, so you can flatten it out a little bit there, see how it's looking. So now I'm going to do 2 double crochets in the first stitch, and then 1 double crochet in the next stitch. It's curling a little bit. I'm okay with that. Okay, now for this one, we're gonna do 2 single crochets in the first stitch, then 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches. And we're gonna repeat that all the way around. Okay, now the next row we're going to do 2 double crochets in the first stitch and then 1 double crochet in the next 3 stitches. Let's see, how many inches we think this is? Probably 4. What do we think here? This is about slight flat. About 4.5. Alright, so now we're going to do 2 in the first stitch. And then 1 double crochet in the next 4. And we're going to repeat that all the way around. Thank you. just measure it again. Let's see where you're at now. You're at 6, so I think one more row should have us. One more row. And we'll have it as wide as we need it. 2 in the first stitch, and 1 double crochet in the next 5. All right, now let's lay it back out as flat as we can get it anyway, because this is going to curl some. Oh yeah, that's plenty big enough now. So now what we're going to do is we're going to just work around it. Just keep on going, working in the round, all the way around, 1 stitch in each stitch all the way around. So we're going to chain 2. We're just going to do 1 double crochet in each stitch all the way around. We're going to keep doing this until we get the height that we need it. again and see how long you are now. So you're about 7.5 or so now. So that's probably about where I want you. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start our ruffle. So I'm actually gonna take that out. All right, so I'm going to slip stitch to this first stitch I made, and I'm gonna cut this yarn right here. And then I'm going to attach my really pretty till yarn here. Oof, ah, there's the end on this side. Some red mixed in there. So I'm just gonna attach my till yarn here.
So here I'm just grabbing that till yarn and I'm going to pull it through, and I'm gonna do chain two, and I'm gonna do 3 double crochets in each stitch, the front loop only, all the way around. I'm gonna tie that in the back so it's secure.
Chain two, and now I'm going to do 3 double crochets in each stitch around, and I'm actually going to do it not in this back bump. You see this bump right here, not there. I'm going to do it in this front loop right here. So I'm going to use this front loop right here. So you see, here's a back loop and there's a front loop. So I'm going to do it in that front loop right there. So I'm going to do 3 double crochets in each stitch all the way around, and just in that front loop. All right, now we're gonna slip stitch the first one we made. Okay, and now what we're going to do is we're going to chain three. So one, two, three. And now we're going to do a triple crochet in each stitch around. I'm going to start in the stitch that the chain came from. So just one triple crochet in each stitch all the way around.
All right, so now I just slip stitch to the first stitch I made, and I like that. I think it looks really cute. So now I'm just going to cut my yarn, and I'm going to just pull my hook through there, and then I'm going to...
All right, guys, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to weave in my ends here. So I do that really quick, and I cut my fingernails so I can't thread stuff like I could before. So yay me. I'm just going to do this. It's been a while since I've used one of these. So here, I'm just going to work in my yarn. Okay, now I am just taking some of my yarn here and I'm splitting it. And I'm going to thread it onto the smaller needle here. That way I can sew my little button on. So here I marked where I want my button. So what I did was I just tried it on, and so you can look at the back of your work and see that this is kind of the halfway point. So I folded it in half like this, and then I just kind of to the right here of the halfway point, I just marked it kind of where I want it here. So I'm just going to put my yarn needle in here and I'm going to attach it to the back. Now I'm going to thread this through. I'm going to remove my marker here. I'm going to put in my little button right here. I'm going to put it in this direction because I like the color variation from this direction. I'm just going to sew this on right like this. I think I'm going to go ahead and just tie this together also, just to make sure it's super, super secure. And go ahead and just cut this off. And if you wanted to put a little fabric glue on there too, just to make sure it's really on there, that's probably a good idea also. All right, guys, there you have it. You have our cute little bucket hat with the our cute little ruffle bucket hat with a button detail.
Thanks everyone for watching my channel. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me. And I hope you enjoyed making this just as much as I did. Happy hooking, everyone.